Hello, everybody, and welcome to the free game of the month, November 2024 edition. And today we are playing Transmissions, Element 120. This is, as you can probably tell, a free little... on something. A free little game based in the Half-Life universe. Now, where am I supposed to be going? Yes. Even though this does appear to be Half-Life 2, there are technically two different versions of this game. There is a... There is a mod version where you can download it from, I think it is ModDB. I could be wrong on that though. And then, oh, I have a crowbar. Cool. But you can download it from, I believe it is ModDB. And then apply that mod to a pre-existing Half-Life 2 game that you own. Or there is the free Steam version, which I do not believe requires Half-Life 2. So I believe you can just go to Steam and download this for free and play it. Get some nice Half-Life 2 action. Ah. Oh good, I still have my flashlight. Get over here, you. Yeah. That really hurt. So when you boot the game up, it recommends some suit. It recommends that you play the game in a dark environment. So I turned all the lights off in my room, which that causes two problems. Ooh, why not? Looking too good. I already have a pistol now. Okay. Right. How about you? That does cause a few issues, the first one being that bright white flash was really painful in a completely dark room. And number two, the keyboard that I use has no backlighting. Yeah, the keyboard I use has no backlighting. Means that I don't know where my keys are. Combine. But yes, so this is based in the Half-Life 2 universe. And as you can probably tell already, it does have some horror elements to it. So it is a primarily a first-person shooter with a little bit of exploration. I don't believe Transmissions has a particularly lengthy runtime, but there are Steam achievements. So again, if you're into that sort of stuff, then have at it. I have played the original Half-Life 2 before. So, I kind of know what to expect. I'm just conserving ammunition at the moment. Is there any way to, like, get in here? Because there's a suit charger and some energy and stuff, but I'm not... Unless I can stack some stuff. That's a little high to stack, though. That is a combine lock. Okay. Yes, but yeah, Half-Life 2, if you haven't played it, you should go play it, because it is a phenomenal game. Zoom and decode. Breathless cannot see in the dark. Oh, hi. I assume that would be the Breathless. Huzzah. Were you in the... quick. Oh, I turned you around. Okay. So yes, I have not played this before, but I have played... Whoopsies. The original... I'm scared. Hello, gentlemen. Okay, well, this is an interesting predicament to be in. Yeah, so if I remember what I saw on the internet correctly, this does not have a particularly lengthy runtime. So I think it's usually, for a normal playthrough, like 30 minutes to an hour. But it is just a completely free Half-Life 2 expansion that has good reviews. So cannot really go wrong with that. Even, which way do we go? Go to the Lambda insignia. Usually in the original game, that meant goodies. Also using the crowbar to conserve ammunition. It appears might be limited. Like this. Oh, hello. I'm being shot at now. Oh, there's one over there. Okay. That, that did not exactly go as planned. Yep, there's a turret down there. I see how it is. Ooh, that is... that is very spooky. Yeah, this does seem to have a bit more... Zombies can't see in the dark. Okay, we are getting mysterious fluorescent messages. Aha, speaking of zombies. Let's take that one out. That is quite a few of them. I assume we're gonna have to turn this off. And kind of just sneak past them. Yeah, one other thing I wanted to mention is that... how are we gonna pull this off? Veiled in the black of night. So yeah, it looks like we have to turn that thing off. Where's this light coming from? I have no idea. Oh yeah, I was saying, one other thing I wanted to mention. Is that... is that this game does, even though it is... Is there a ladder somewhere? Right there. even though that this is based on Half-Life 2, the requirements to run it do seem a little bit higher. Ooh, up we go. Here we go. So yes, the... Oops. Classic Half-Life loading screen. The requirements to run it do seem a bit higher, so even if you can run... Cannot seem to scan those. Even if you can run normal Half-Life 2 competently, this game may be a bit of a struggle. Ah, yes. Ubiquitous vents. What is going to come out and scare me? I should have played this for October. Oh, we're back in here. Okay. Yes, this is a little bit of a spooky game. It's like the original Half-Life 2 set of games, that being 2, Episode 1 and Episode 2, did have like... Oops. Ow. That hurt. Did it have, like, some... Oh, I can push stuff. Oops. Did it have some horror elements to them? But they weren't, like, this. What are you? They weren't this bad. Also, there's some reflections. I don't recall seeing that in any Half-Life game. Hello, what are you? Oh my goodness! That's not the gravity gun I remember. can I read this? I need instructions, help. Built a weapon at 45 degree angle or greater. Jump while simultaneously firing. Jump simultaneously... Jump... Excuse me, music, could you calm down, please? Jump while simultaneously firing the weapon. The device can additionally be used to break your fall. Uh-huh. So normally, in Half-Life 2, there's this thing called the gravity gun, which you know, pick up and, fling objects around, which is what I was expecting to happen, not fire giant energy blasts. Ouch! Can I... Whee! Interesting. I'm stuck. Good grief. Well, guess we have a rocket jump. device from Team Fortress 2. Sure. Close that. Ooh, computer. Computer, yes. What do you have? Can I flip you over? Can I flip you over? Not really much. Looks like you have a... you have a disk drive. That's good. Your disk drive is still installed. Looks like a whole lot of nothing. That looks like that could maybe be a... power supply? I don't know. Computer's a lost cause. Okay, but I can pick this up. Can I? Yes, there we go. And a shotgun. Okay. Picking up fun gravity gun thing and a shotgun at the same time. That is always nice. And I think that, I think I might leave things off here then. I'll give you a nice, nice taste of what exactly transmissions element 120 is about. Basically, just a little bit more Half-Life and completely for free. Which you cannot go wrong with that. Do keep in mind it is a little bit more taxing to run than normal Half-Life 2. But not too bad. Because I am running it basically maxed out settings right now. It's not too bad. And I don't exactly have the most powerful computer in the world. Yeah. So, there's a free Steam version. Has achievements. Cool shoot-a-bang gravity gun. Something fell down up there. And not too long of a runtime. Yeah. Also, I do completely recommend following their suggestion of playing this in a dark room, even if you're like me and use a Lenovo keyboard from like 2007 that does not have backlights. We all make do with what we have. But anyways, I shall leave that off here and stop pacing and rambling as I like to do. So thank you very much for watching. I will see you next month, or whatever that game will be. I haven't quite decided yet. And take care. Drink your water. Bye-bye.